What's going on, guys? Blame Truth here, the Codfather himself, bringing you another video. And guys, I hate to even make this video. I truthfully do, because there is not a single ounce of positivity in today's video. There's none. I hear you guys saying, BT, you should be more positive for a change. Guys, if I had something to be positive about, I would love to bring you positive videos. The last positive video I made was about Black Ops 2, because there's nothing in current day Call of Duty, especially the multiplayer portion, that is positive, that's remotely positive. But anyway, I'm gonna bring you this horrible news after a brief word from this video's sponsor. Today's video is sponsored by Opera GX Browser, and guys, I absolutely love this browser because it gives me complete control when it comes to surfing the internet. The first thing I love about Opera GX is actually the GX Control Center. So what this does is it lets you pretty much dial in exactly how much CPU and RAM you are willing to let the browser use. So if you're multitasking, gaming, listening to music while editing or something like that, this lets you just free up resources that could better be used elsewhere. And on top of that, it also has a network limiter, so this lets you limit the network bandwidth used by the Opera GX browser to gain performance in games and streams and what have you. And just to compare the resources between the two, here's Google Chrome and here's Opera GX, and both are just bone stock. You could see the difference just tweaking some settings makes here. Opera GX is integrated with Twitch and Discord as well, so you can just pull those up right in the sidebar. You don't have to open up the apps. It's just super convenient. GX Corner is also a very unique feature to Opera GX. You can stay up to date with free games, the best deals, the newest releases, and breaking gaming news all in one easily accessible place. And this has to be my favorite feature as someone that doesn't like the retinas burned by all these websites I come across. You can force dark pages automatically with Opera GX. Thank you for saving my eyes from like the New York Post, Opera, seriously. Opera GX has so many other great features, guys. This is my browser of choice. Get yours by clicking the link in the video description, and happy browsing. All right, guys, welcome back to the video here. So let's get down to the nitty gritty. I'm gonna try to summarize it. I'll link the full article. It's all rumors. That's like the only positive thing I could say. It could not end up happening. It's not set in stone. It's rumors. Take it with a grain of salt. It's by a popular leaker, Ralph's Valve. I'm just gonna put a Modern Warzone's tweet here on the matter. So Doug says, there are plans to reshape how SBMM works in Modern Warfare 2, but disbanding lobbies are here to stay, according to a report from one of the most credible leakers in the Call of Duty scene, Ralph's Valve. New plans for this system include matchmaking bot pools that will counter smurfs. So what are smurfs? Well, smurfs are smurf accounts, which it's basically a way for people to reverse boost and get into easier lobbies, because this system punishes everyone who is remotely good at this game. It puts them in harder lobbies. It does not give them any reward for working harder. In fact, it just punishes you by making your connection worse. But after the colossal failure that was Call of Duty Vanguard, they're finally reworking the system. And let's be honest, it was a failure when it was first introduced, and they've been bleeding players ever since. MW 2019 bled players. Cold War bled more players. Vanguard has bled the most. And now, finally, they're reworking it. But if this is to be believed, if this article is true, they are missing the fucking point entirely. Let's get back to it, though, and read some more of this clown shit, all right? Matchmaking bot pools. With the breakdown of the SBMM system, there are allegedly plans to incorporate bot pools, which is PvPvE, so bots in the multiplayer, on the condition that the player statistics are eligible to enter these lobbies. So for really bad players, they're going to get put into lobbies with bots and whatnot, essentially, to make them feel good or something. I don't know. With the overhaul in AI, they'll be able to track a player's level of skill throughout the match, leveling and countering smurfs, which is, you know, the bad accounts that you join session on, or outright removing the player from the matches. So if a guy is too good, he's just going to get kicked out of the lobby, whether he's in there legit or not. From the sound of it, I don't know, man. What a bunch of fucking shit. Let's go back to it here. There's more. An associate close to COD describes SBMM as a complicated but pragmatic system. We're always looking for ways on improving every facet that contributes to a product's success. That's the initiative. SBMM is one of those things, as it's really a matter of trial and error. SBMM plays an important role in sustaining a thriving player base. Is that why you've bled players for 3 years strong now, you fucking morons? And with Vanguard failing to meet expectations, Activision has had the chance with wiping the slate clean and reviewing the system in place. A collective R&D, research and development effort from several studios contributing towards creating a liberal yet sensible system, a system that accommodates all brackets of skill, high and low. An associate briefly mentioned that the new framework would become less debilitating for the better margin of players instead of penalizing them, whilst allowing for a protected bracket to coexist for lower skilled players. And all that sounds, I guess, decent on paper. But why are you overcomplicating something so simple? It's bound to fail because it's not what gaming should be. Make the game and the players will sort all this out on their own. Make the game good. It doesn't matter. Protect the little Timmy No Thumbs. Protect the blind kids if you must. But for God fucking sakes, man, give us something. Give the better players something to work towards. If you're gonna have this system at all, it doesn't matter if you tone it down, it doesn't matter if you fix it, until you have put connection first, until you have given us something to work towards, until you stop disbanding the lobbies so we can actually have a social gaming experience like we did back in the day, until you can make matchmaking as quick as it was in, oh, I don't know, Black Ops 2, until my ping to the server stays below 50 milliseconds consistently like it did in Black Ops 4. That game was not released that long ago, but that was the last Call of Duty before they came up with this dog shit system that puts you in 100 plus ping lobbies. Until you go back to basics, it's going to fail, and you're wasting your fucking time like we will be wasting our time if we play your shitty goddamn game with this overcomplicated bullshit system in play. Can I get a goddamn amen in the comment section? I don't know why they have such, like, a hard-on for overcomplicating the multiplayer portion of COD. If Warzone is their main bread and butter, if that's the main thing that's selling, keep your SBMM shit in that. Seriously, keep it in that. Keep it in Warzone 2. Leave multiplayer alone. If you don't care about it, just leave it the fuck alone. They've got these, I don't know, virgin-ass scientists doing these experiments saying, well, to get the player retention high, we want to put this pragmatic algorithm in that will match them based on a skill level, but not give them any reward for actually accomplishing anything. Like, it just doesn't make any fucking sense. It's like, a game is supposed to be fun. What's fun in a game? A sense of progression? A sense of progression and an enjoyable experience along the way. It's not so much the destination as it is the journey with multiplayer and Call of Duty. In fact, multiplayer and Call of Duty has never really had a destination except for maybe prestige mode, which everyone can get with enough time, except they remove that too. The joy of Call of Duty was just the gameplay. It was playing. It was hopping on and using a different setup. Maybe you're not using a meta setup. Maybe you're using like a Scorpion in Black Ops 1, like a dual-wield Scorpion. You're running around having fun. And the fun of it was seeing if you could get like a chopper gunner and a Blackbird and a good score while using this off-kilter setup. It was like, can I beat these guys using some of the best stuff in the game because I'm better than them using some not-so-good stuff in the game? These teams are not talented enough to bring us a balanced experience anymore. So anything with SBMM in it is going to fail because you don't have the talent to balance the game. Okay, if SBMM was in the game, and I mean it is in the game, but if it's in the game and it's here to stay, balance the fucking game accordingly. I want every weapon and every perk to be competitive. You can't do that. You can't even give us something to work towards. If I'm better than the average bear, what is my reward? Where is it? Even playing league play, what the hell do I get? Everything that's remotely interesting is locked away in the store behind a $25 paywall. It makes no goddamn sense. I'm sorry for yelling, but how am I like the only one that sees this? How are there so many dumbass Call of Duty fanboys that even if you don't like me, can you not agree that the system's kind of busted and it makes no sense? I'm just not addicted to gambling, I guess. I'm not addicted to the loot boxes. I never was. I'm not addicted to buying $80 skins that made me look like a fucking virgin that I didn't earn. But you know what I was addicted to? Elden Ring. Elden Ring had no complicated systems. Elden Ring didn't handhold. It didn't even have an easy mode. And it sold like hotcakes. It got 10 out of 10s across the board. It is game of the year. It went back to basics. It brought us a good, fun game with no shitty gimmicks. That's all I want. Stop overcomplicating the simplest fucking thing. Leave that shit to Boarzone and leave my multiplayer alone, you jackasses. I'm out of time, and I want to suplex Joe Sekhot through a big old stack of pancakes. Peace out.